In this video, we are going to see various types of read-only memories. Basically, read-only memory means non-volatile. Means the stored information can be retained even though the power is not supplied continuously. And that is the reason why we store the programs which are used to boot your systems. And it is also used extensively in embedded systems. We require a special writing process when compared to the RAM, that is random access memories, ROM. So this is how your ROM cell will be constructed. In the case of read operation, the word line is activated. Here we are supposed to activate this word line. The transistor is closed when we are activating this word line. So the voltage on the bit line drops to the near zero if there is a connection between the transistor and the ground. So this one. So in order to store zero, we are supposed to connect this. And if we want to store one, this is not connected. So here, this connection should not be there. If we want to store one, it should be there if we want to store zero. And in the case of write operation, it is done during the manufacturing process only. That is, in each cell, this connection will be there or not, it will be decided and done only during manufacturing time. PROM, the next type of ROM, that is programmable ROM, programmable read-only memory. So in this case, instead of having done directly during the manufacturing time, this connection we call it as a fuse. If we burn this fuse, we say that one is stored. If we don't burn this, then zero itself will be there. Because it is connected, when it is not fused, then we say that zero will be there in that particular cell. If we fuse it, then we say that one is written in the particular cell. So programmability is achieved by inserting a fuse at a point P. So memory contains all zeros before programming. So during manufacturing time, everything will be connected. All cells will be connected like this. So wherever we want to insert one, that particular cells need to be fused by passing a high current to that particular cells. So this process is irreversible. So once we fuse it, again we will not be able to connect it. So provides flexibility and convenience not available in the ROM. When compared to the ROM, PROM provides better flexibility. ROM is suitable when high volumes of data is required. EPROM, erasable programmable ROM. Contents can be erased and reprogrammed, can be erased with a ultraviolet rays, so must be physically removed from the circuit for reprogramming. Entire contents are erased. So once the EPROM chip is manufactured and if we have programmed it once, then it is possible to reprogram that, but the disadvantage is we are supposed to physically remove that particular thing and reprogram it. And while reprogramming, we will not be able to reprogram only few contents, but complete entire, all the contents should be erased and again do the programming part. That is the case of EPROM. EEPROM, electrically erasable programmable ROM. Erasing will be done electrically. Do not have to be removed for erasure. In the case of EPROM, we have just now seen that to reprogram it, the chip need to be physically removed. But in the case of EEPROM, we need not remove it physically. And also, the other difference is all the contents need to be erased in order to reprogram in the case of EPROM. But in the case of EEPROM, selected cells can be erased and reprogrammed. But the disadvantage is different voltages are needed for erasing, writing and reading the stored data. Flash memory. read individual cells is possible in the case of flash memory. Write in blocks. We can read from individual cells, but we can write in blocks together. Prior to writing, the previous contents of the block are erased. Greater density, higher capacity and low cost per bit. This is the advantage of the flash memory. Require single power supply voltage. If you see in the case of EEPROM, we require different voltages for reading, writing and erasing. But in the case of flash memory, single power supply voltage is enough. Consume less power. And the applications of the flash memory are handheld computers, cell phones, digital cameras and MP3 music players and many more. These are the various types of ROM. Thank you.